let's all stand to our feet and just come around the front just for a few minutes before we start our church service. It's good to see everyone here tonight. Oh God, God's been good to us. Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise God, praise God. Give me some lights out here. It's not as bad with these stronger lights on me. There you go. Turn them down, please, just a little bit for right now. Yes. It's all right. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Well, I hope that you've had a good week so far, because I want the Lord to bless you. You know, one day, we're going to put this body away, and we're going to serve God with a glorified body. And I don't know about you, but one day I'm looking forward to that day. And chances are, when you get to heaven one day, you're going to reminisce, and you're going to think about earth. You're going to think about what you did down here. You're going to think about the times that you overcome, and you're going to be thankful. And you're going to be thankful about the fellowship that you had down here with friends. And they love God the same way you love God, and you're going to spend eternity with them. I'm going to tell you something, folks. You might as well fall in love with your pastor, because you're going to live with me eternity. You might as well like me now. Get some good practice. Because if you don't like me now, you're not going to like me there, because I'm going to do more up there than I am down here. I'm going to really be an actor up there. Praise God. Amen. You know, seriously, laying all jokes aside, I really believe that. I believe that if you can't love me down here and I can't love you down here. I was praying today, and I'm serious about this. I have no enemies. Put a name on it, put a face on it. I cannot find them anywhere. I have no enemies. I don't want to talk to anybody down. I don't want to talk against anybody. Man, I'm going to tell you something. You get 61 years old, you find out this is not a flesh and blood battle. And if you a flesh and blood battle, you in the wrong battle, baby. You're on the wrong side of the fence. If you're fighting people instead of devils, you're on the wrong side, baby. I want to let you know that right now. Sound like a Baptist church in here, Catholic or Presbyterian. You need to really say hallelujah on that. That's a revelation. If you ever come to the place where you got your battles under the blood, and you don't hate anybody, you don't despise anybody, you don't have aught against anybody, there's no unforgiveness in your spirit, and you really, the love of God is coming through. Listen, you have conquered a whole lot. You've done a lot of conquering when you come to that place. But if you're still on the earth and you battle relationships and you can't really don't, that person gets on my nerves and that person don't do it like me because I don't like them because they don't do it like me. I'm telling you right now, you are in a battle for the rest of your life down here. You better learn to give it over to God, because I'm going to tell you something. It will destroy you from the roots up, baby. Learn to love people and learn to have no enemies upon the earth. None. I hate to go in my office when I know somebody's wrought. I hate to deal with that spirit. I do, man. I love to be with people that can laugh and they don't have an edge on them. Come on, get rid of all that stuff. Get rid of it. Get rid of it. My. And I'm not trying to think some things are going on. That's not my motive tonight. I'm just saying we're people. We are people, man. We are flesh and bones, buddy. We blood. And we can have problems. And if you got people problems, you got real problems. Praise God. If you got a husband that's going crazy on you, and you got a wife that's going crazy on you, you got kids that are crazy, you have to learn to put them in God's hands, buddy. And I'm telling you right now, when God gets through with them, you won't have to put a hand on them. You won't have to touch it. If I can't handle you in here, sick 'em, Holy Ghost. God, I can't do nothing with them, Lord. God, just take care of it. And God does it in time. Praise God. But you know what? Relatively, we got some good people here. And I'm enjoying my journey. Just want to let y'all know that. So I'm not putting anybody's in God's hands. And don't feel fretful that Brother Chandler's out to get me. No, 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 no. Brother Chandler's okay. I like the journey. I like what's going on. And God's doing great things around here. And I am on it, buddy. I love it. I love it. I love it. Thank God for our new people. John, it's good to have you and Amy and George and Cece. And I'm just looking around random here. Amen. Love this couple here. Glad to have y'all with us. Amen. Amen. I love and appreciate y'all and praying for your daughter. Praying that God will get a hold of her. Praise God. Amen. A strong family. The strong family gets stronger every day around here, don't they? Praise God. Love them. Praise God. Let's give all of our new ones a hand. And the Hinkles, I'm glad to have them with us tonight. Amen. Love the Hinkle family. Amen. Praise God. We can't forget Elizabeth. Elizabeth, we almost didn't make it without you and Brandon this past weekend. Almost. But we did survive. Just want to let you know. Brandon and Elizabeth Carter, their family. And Frank Munoz. Oh, look out now. The tambourine man. Love that guy. Don't you like him? These are some relatively new folks in the past year with us. And it's good to have all of them with us tonight. Praise God. Let's worship tonight. And as musicians come forward, we're going to have a good old Holy Ghost time tonight. Man, I like this. I like apostolic. We're different folks, and we do different strokes for different folks, and folks for different strokes, don't we? Around here, praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Clap your hands unto the Lord. Praise God. Brother and Sister Irwin, we love you guys. I'm glad that y'all are here tonight. Praise God. God to do great things for y'all. Amen. All right. Y'all ready to hit it, get it, and go? Are you ready? On your mark. Get set. Let's go. Praise God. Thank you.
shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcomed here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Unto the Lord. He's worthy of every praise tonight. Hallelujah, God. Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah. The Lord has been dealing with my wife and I, and I'm not going to steal her message that she's going to talk to the church eventually on, but I am going to give you a preview of it. And I want to say this, church, I want to do some things different here. All of your programs and all of your spending all your money going out on the streets, and that's all good. I like all that. That's good and well. Have nothing against that. And your programs and your all of your beautiful rooms that you're fixing up, and your all your efforts of your energy far as physical going into this church is good. I have nothing against that. Feeding the poor, you know, going out on the streets and witnessing, telling people about the Lord, having street services or block parties and all this. I'm not against any of that. But I'm going to tell you where we're missing it. If you will spend about 90% of your time in prayer and bathing yourself with your relationship with God, your anointing will increase and you'll see more done in a short time than you will all of this toil that you're doing and all this spending money buying vans and going out and getting kids and all that's good and well, but I'm going to tell you something. If you're not bathing some things in prayer, we have missed it, church. We have missed it. We're no different than the denominational church down the street with all of their beautiful programs. And they can outdo us because they got a lot of money. They can outdo us on the programs. And the more liberal you get, the more money they've got. And the more holiness that you are, it eliminates the wealth. They don't like that. But it draws the needy. And they don't have a dime in their pocket. They come in needing something. And I'm not against that. And we ought to do that. We don't draw the doctors in the law. Jesus never drawed them. He never drew them to him. He never could get their attention because they had need of nothing. Now, if we want to change some things, we can get their programs and their liberalism, and we'll draw the doctors and the lawyers and the money in the money bags. We can do that. But I will not cross over my conviction. I believe it's time that we stand up and build this thing God's way. He's got a way. He's got a direction for this church. And I'm going to start presenting that to you. This coming to church and teaching Sunday school classes and walking around and no prayer, you're going to wrestle your way down to the floor and you ain't going nowhere, baby. Come and flipping papers and prayer and doing this and doing that and adjusting that. Honey, you ain't going nowhere. I know you don't like it, but I'm going to tell you anyhow. We don't like that. I mean, that hits our flesh. Because I'm used to doing it this way, Pastor. Get out of that. Because God's going to back me up, not you. Praise God, praise God. I feel like that we're in our season, that God wants to send revival, but we're doing it the hard way. We're doing it, come on now, we're doing it the hard way. We want to come late for prayer, and we don't want to spend time with God, and we want to do our programs, and we want to spend money here and spend money there. Oh, come on, church. Man, my wife, we are on it, buddy. I'm telling you, we're getting some direction in this thing. We have some prayer warriors in this church that are hidden. They are hidden nuggets. And I'm not talking about, I'm talking about golden nuggets. They're hidden in this congregation, ready to be, to come forth. I feel that. I really feel that. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of the wrestling match. I'm ready to see. I see on Facebook and I hear of Holy Ghost crusades, and man, they prayed 17. Of course, there might be bigger churches. I don't know. They prayed 17 through to the Holy Ghost and 10 got baptized. Next week, the same thing happened. The next week, the same thing happened. this thing just don't happen on programs. Somebody's getting committed. And I'm not talking about the insane asylum committed. I'm talking about committed to the things of God. I'm excited about our Hispanics that are coming here, and I don't know how to word that. Y'all forgive me if I word it wrong. You're not crossing the border from Mexico. You Americans, folks, okay? So we'll just say our American Hispanics movement in Lockhart. I'm excited about that. We're starting a Bible study there next Saturday. They're hungry for God. And I'm going over there with a prayer and fasting attitude, and I'm going to give it my best to set that city on fire. Who knows the future? We may start a work over there. I'm all for it. Man, listen, I'm getting cranked up at 61. I'm getting cranked up at 61. I'm busier now, Brother Strong, than I have been when I was 51 years old in this church. Why? Because I'm getting a little bit more organized. I'm getting a little bit more under my belly, so to speak. I'm getting a hold of some things more than I did then. I am ready. I am ready. It's all about reaching the hurting, reaching those people that are sick, afflicted, and need God. Hallelujah. My. I'm ready. I am ready. Praise God. And all of our new ones, I'm tip my hat at you. And I'm excited about next Saturday. I'm thinking about it. It's coming Saturday. Wow. Wow. We've already got it in concrete, and I love it. And ain't no telling what's going to happen. Praise God. Let's all stand our feet and give tonight as God has blessed you. And I'm spinning. Y'all take me right when I say this. I'm going to spend a little bit less time in reading and studying, which I do all the time. And I'm going to transfer that into prayer meetings, connecting with God. Then He will talk to me about preaching, ministering, and speak to me about messages that I minister, and He will talk to me about what to feed this flock, and then I can go back and open my Bible and open up and begin to the Holy Ghost begin to show me. Boom, 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 wow, wow, boom. Instead of going in and doing all my stuff, and I've done this, I'm not good. Probably you have too. And I've gone in, man, Saturday here, I spent all day Saturday, man, I'm racking my brain, and I'm trying to do this, and I'm trying to do that, and trying to get something together for Sunday morning, and man, I just can't get it, man, I'm nervous, don't know. And I said, God, I'm going to be an airhead Sunday morning if I don't get some. Oh, God, I'm scared to death. And I get up here, my knees almost knocking, you know. And God, I'm hoping I'm preaching the right message today. And singing the right song. Doing the right thing. You said it. You said it. You got to let the Holy Ghost do it. And the only way the Holy Ghost can do it is get away from some programs.
All right. That's right.
My wife, she tells me sometimes, I said, man, I got to study. She says, well, just pray. Just pray. You don't have a lot of time to study. Just pray. I said, yeah, right. About half made me mad because I'm depending on my brain more than I am prayer meetings, and I'm not going to do that anymore. I can pray and get the mind of God, the mind of the Spirit, And you don't see me on Facebook. I'm getting off of a lot of that stuff. I'm sick and tired of Facebook. Tired of it. Don't need no fanfares. Don't need to see what they say about me. It's all about what he says about me. Come on, church. Sometimes I think, now y'all let me talk just a few minutes. Sometimes I think all of this technology stuff, iPhones and iPads and all that, if we're not careful, will become our biggest enemy in the kingdom things. So I'm you hadn't seen me much on Facebook. I get on there every now and then, but I'm just about deleting it out because I'm sick of it stealing my time from God. Tired of it. That's why it gets under my craw if I see somebody out here that needs to be listening to the preaching. They're on their iPhone back there in the corner. Don't do that. Don't do that. I don't want to get on all of y'all, but I just want to set some stage, okay? Just, you know, don't get on them iPhones, not during church service. Don't flip pages in the Bible thinking and pretending you're reading the Bible when you need to be listening to the man of God, whoever's behind this pulpit. I don't care who they are. I understand if you're on your iPad and you're looking up scriptures. I understand that. I'm for that, or iPhone. But if you on that iPhone and you're looking up Facebook and you're, and I go home and find out, I look on Facebook and I find out at 7:45, I see so-and-so was on Facebook and they came to church. You told off on yourself. Don't look at me as I'm griping tonight. I'm a revivalist, and I got to get this thing in order, man, or it'll fly out in the wrong direction. Let's raise our hands and love God now. Somebody's going to love God tonight. So if y'all see some people in here that's going on their iPhones, I give you permission to say, didn't Pastor tell you to put that stupid thing up? Come on, let me preach it now. Didn't Pastor tell you to put that crazy thing up? Well, I know. Y'all ready to give to the Lord? Let's stand our feet. That didn't cost you a thing tonight. In church, I promise you, I'm doing everything under passion tonight because there's nothing in my spirit of gripe and murmur, complain and bellyache. I promise you that. I promise you. You can count on it. Because I prayed a couple hours this evening before I ever come to this church because I'm getting more serious with God. I'm getting more serious with God. You know what I have to do? And I know I'm talking. I have to get so sick and tired of some stuff. You have to too. You have to get tired of it before you'll dump it out. I'm hiding me in the cleft of the rock. I don't even want to be seen. Don't even mention my name. Just hide me in the cleft of the rock, and man, I'll be happy. Because I want to be in those secret, hidden places with God. And when I come to this pulpit, I'm ready. I'm ready to deliver what God has given me. And those that are behind this pulpit, I want them to do the same thing. That's my dream and my vision for this church. Father, bless those that give tonight. Father, put a revival spirit in every heart tonight. Father, I pray over every soul here tonight, God, that you would minister grace and mercy and love and passion. Father, we love you, God, because you're everything to us. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, I pray over them. Cover them. Cover their family members. And everybody say in Jesus' name, come and give to the Lord as God has blessed you.
the Lord, everybody. I'm so glad to be here today. How about you guys? So coming up on Friday, we've got some changes. At 6 p.m., there's going to be a men's outing. We're going to meet here at 6, and then we're going to do dinner in town. I say we're. The men are going to do dinner in town. 6:30 p.m., youth and college and career event at the Coates home. Sister Sarah has invited the youth and college and career out to her home for an event on Friday night. So if you're interested in coming, come here at 6:30, and we're going to drive the van out for that. So coming up on Sunday, we've got 8:15 praise practice, 9 a.m. prayer, 10 a.m. Sunday school, and 11 a.m. worship service. Coming up next week, October 9th and 10th, Austin First Church, which is right down the road. Y'all still hear me? There we go. There's a spiritual warfare prayer training conference, and it's supposed to be really awesome. It starts Friday morning at 9 a.m. and goes till 4 p.m. on Saturday. And it is $20 if you register by Friday at the South Texas District, or it's $25 at the door. Also, on October 17th, we're having a Hill Country Men's Conference here at POB. Any men that are planning to attend that, can y'all stand up so we can get a head count? The men's conference here at the Pentecostals of Bastrop. October 17th. So it is 2 weeks from Saturday. So about 10. And then also on October, what ages are we saying? Just come. Okay. And then also on October 24th, we're going to have a fall festival. It's also going to be an outreach tool. So if we can get volunteers, we'll need people to run booths, we'll need people to make cotton candy, people to man a bounce house, you name it, we're going to need help. So if you guys are interested in helping with that, please let me know, and then we'll be scheduling a meeting next week to start the actual planning of that. So anything else that I missed? Okay, thanks y'all.
If you will be in prayer for Jennifer. She's not here tonight. Jennifer lost her cousin. He was killed, murdered at gunpoint, and she's very distraught about it. So keep Jennifer in your prayers. Jennifer is a new one. She's a new one here, been here probably 6-8 months, maybe a year. But she's needing the church to back her up. And you that want to go to the funeral tomorrow at 10 o'clock at the Catholic Church, Providence Baptist Church, Providence, okay, Providence Funeral Home, okay, Providence Funeral Home, and if you'd like to go to that funeral at 10 tomorrow, it's, I'm sure she would appreciate you attending that. Praise God. Brother Strong is going to speak to us tonight, and I just like to do this to our guys. Love Brother Strong. He's loved around this church. Got a great balance. Got a good ministry. He's got good relationships here. Great relationships here. Amen. And I appreciate him. Brother Strong, come on up here and minister to us tonight. Everybody say, God bless Brother Strong.
God bless me. God bless me. Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone. Amen. After such a miraculous time in the Lord Sunday, I do not feel worthy to even stand here this evening. Amen. What a tremendous, tremendous move of the Lord we had here. And I tell you what, the afterglow was better than the service. Amen. Now, if you had to rush off so that you could get to the restaurant or whatever the case may have been, well, then you just missed it. You missed it. Amen. I tell you, I felt something was imparted to my wife and I when Brother Lewis laid his hands on us. Amen. And I want you to understand that I am not above weeping in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I hope that I have instilled into my sons that it's okay for a man to shed tears. Amen. That does not make you a wimp, and it doesn't make you a girl. Amen. Amen. Yes. Amen. When my mother completed her journey, I wept. When my dad completed his journey, I wept. There is nothing wrong with shedding tears. Amen. Amen. Your manhood is not based on how tough you can be. Amen. Now, Pastor was just talking about these iPads and iPhones, and this silly thing does not want to cooperate. I keep pressing my Bible app, and Facebook keeps popping up. Amen. So if you get home and you see that almost 10 minutes after the hour, Brother Strong was on Facebook, the devil is a lie. Amen. He certainly is. Amen. We'll get there. We'll get there. Amen. Where did my wife take off to? Amen. Man, I need her encouragement. Amen. I don't know how I lived as long as I did without my wife. Amen. I guess it must be, you know, I got accustomed to my mother telling me everything to do. And then I gained a wife. You know what? Some of us men could avoid a lot of issues if we would just listen to our wives. Amen. Amen. It's absolutely the truth. Amen. How often I can look back in raising our boys, you know, when my wife says, "Dear, dear, take a step back." Amen. It could have turned out a lot worse than it did if I hadn't listened. Because you know what? I'm one of these individuals. I'm pretty much easygoing, but when my feathers get riled, move out of my way. Amen. Now, I admit that to you. Amen. I don't profess to be some super powerful Christian. I need him. I need him every day. I need him several times in a day. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. I want to turn your attention this evening to Psalms chapter 42. Amen. Chapter 42 of Psalms. And we're going to read just three verses this evening. Amen. Thank you, Lord. And while you're turning to Psalms chapter 42, I wonder if you can see up here. You see what I'm holding? Amen. What do you perceive that to be? A bottle of water? Anybody else? What do you perceive this to be? H2O keeps you from dehydration. Amen. Brother Irwin, you're getting into my message. A plastic bottle of water. Amen. I'm going to set that right there. In fact, the back of it says hydrate. Amen. Psalms 42, beginning with verse 1. As the heart panteth after the water brooks, so panteth my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night, while they continually say unto me, where is thy God? Amen. Backing up to verse 1, as the heart panteth after the water brooks. Does anybody understand what that word heart means there? It is not this thing in the middle of our chest that's pumping our blood. A heart, if I'm correct, is a young deer. Any hunters in here? Donovan Hunter? Amen. Am I correct? Amen. So as the young deer panteth after the water brook, amen. Down in Florida where we came from, there, it was a common thing to have these little young deers that would come out of the woods. And it was generally after a hard rain, and you could see them stoop down in the ditches, licking water. Amen. So panteth my soul after thee, O God. You may be seated. Amen. For just a few moments, I want to introduce to you this thought. Amen. Liquid life. Liquid life. Amen. There is a flowering plant that is at the corner of our 6x30-foot travel trailer, almost near the front door. And it was looking very poor this morning, in fact, drooping and appeared nearly dead. I went to the sink and I brought water to the front stoop and I saturated the plant and I went about my business. Oh, probably a couple of hours or less maybe went by. And I went back out the front door. And as I came outside, I was confronted with a total transformation. My first thought was, I wish I had taken a before picture. Amen. I was astounded. I exclaimed to myself, it's like a miracle. Of course, it was not a miracle per se, but it did demonstrate the desperate need and tremendous influence of water on our plants. Water, liquid life. Amen. You know, circumstances, stress, and drama. Anybody got drama this evening? If you've got a 15-year-old and 11-year-old in your house, you've got drama. rather of the female or the male version. You've got drama. Amen. Circumstances, stress, and drama can drain us dry. Day by day, and then days turns into weeks. Weeks turns into months. And so on, and so on. And we have become dried out. Now, since we have moved to Texas, I've learned a couple of things about Texas. I already knew that everything was bigger in Texas. I already knew that. The cowboy hats were 8 foot high and 12 foot wide. Amen. Cowboy boots were quite expensive in Texas. Amen. I'm a Floridian at heart. Don't be shocked if you should happen to see me with flip-flops on. Amen. Everything can change in a moment. And no, I was talking about it was okay for a man to cry. I'm not one of these that goes and gets his toenails done. If you do, more power to you. I would be too ashamed to show my toenails to a pedicurist. She would have to crank up a chainsaw. Amen. Amen. But everything can change in a moment's time. Amen. Excuse me. Amen. Three things that can be like water to a thirsty soul. The first thing, when we get into the presence of the Lord, amen, the Holy Ghost water starts flowing. And if we don't, and we tap into it, you know, before you have water, you got to turn the tap on. You can't go to the kitchen sink and expect your glass to get filled and never turn on the tap. You got to turn it on. Amen. Amen. I'm going to tell you how to turn on that Holy Ghost water. Start thanking Him. Start thanking Him. Lord, I thank you today. I thank you today, Lord, for my life, for my health, for everything we have. I thank you, Lord, today. Amen. And the second thing, get in the Word of God. Amen. Get in the Word of God. I don't care where you open that Bible to. There is something about the Word that will water your soul. Hallelujah. Amen. The third thing, a word of encouragement. Amen. David said, I have encouraged myself. Amen. We cannot depend on somebody to encourage us every time we need encouragement. Amen. We got to encourage ourselves in the Lord. Amen. And if you can't think of anything to encourage yourself with concerning the Lord, you need to add a fourth thing to this. Get on your knees and pray. 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 Amen. The acronym PUSH. Pray until something happens. Amen. You'll either get a breakthrough, excuse my screeching voice, or you'll pass out, one of the two. Something will happen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Where did... There she is. Sister Sophia, can I ask you a question? How old are you, dear? What'd she say? 13. Oh, she's doing tremendous. She is doing tremendous. As I was sitting over here, I was watching her. And I could tell she was a little bit tense. But she was doing it. And I thought, I got a soon-to-be 12-year-old son. And he's learning to play the drums. And she's doing so well on the keyboard. I thought, evangelistic team. Amen. You plant a seed, and it will grow. Amen. Amen. And Sister Katrina, I think we could get along with you. I think we could get along with you. And then we'd have some good-looking grandchildren. Amen. Amen. I'm speaking those things that are not as though they were. Amen. Amen. Don't tell me we don't like a matchmake. The Pentecostal churches are full of matchmakers. Amen. Amen. Okay, Sister Sophia, I didn't want to embarrass you. Amen. I saw my son back there take a dive under the chair. Amen. Amen. The point I want to say is don't get too hasty. Don't decide what you are going to do. Let God decide that for you. Amen. Now getting back to my message. Amen. Have you felt like David in his words above, as the hart panteth after the water brook, so panteth my soul after thee. Oh, my God, I have felt that way. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Amen. Excuse me. Have you felt like David in his words above? Have found the answer to your thirst? Amen. Let me back up or regress just a moment. One other thing that I have found out about Texas, and in particular in this area, this is a dry place. Amen. Notice that, Sister Elizabeth? Dry. That's a Georgia, Florida term, dry. Amen. That's like chitlins on a stick. Amen. If anybody don't know what those are, then we'll enlighten you at a later date. Amen. But this is a dry place. I have noticed my throat is continuously dry. Amen. Florida was a wet state. We had water everywhere. You could go to dig a hole to put your plant in it and didn't have to go down but a couple of inches. And water would spring up. Amen. But thankfully, I have found my thirst quencher, the Lord Jesus Christ. In John chapter 7, verses 37 through 39, in the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture saith. Amen. There's a lot of churches in session tonight. Being the traditional Wednesday night. But they're not preaching as the scripture saith. Amen. Amen. As the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. Amen. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Amen. He's glorified now. He's glorified now. Amen. Biblical faith in Jesus Christ connects us to a never-ending source of living water. Amen. Living water. Liquid life. Amen. My family has become a water-drinking family. My wife used to be the big water drinker. But over the last few months, since we've lived in Texas, all of us are drinking much more water. We have went from 3 flats of bottled water a month to 5 flats of bottled water, and sometimes 6 and 7 a month. Amen. In addition to the faucet water that we drink. Now, the faucet water here leaves much to be desired. Amen. Thank the Lord for Britta. Amen. These Brita pitchers, you know, where you can fill it with tap water and it filters it all down for you. Thank the Lord for Brita. Amen. A wonderful thing about this thirst-quenching faith in Jesus is we don't have to wait for the sale at Walgreens to get a flat of water for $2.49. Now, that's a good buy. We don't have to wait for Walmart to put it on sale for $2.29. Amen. We don't have to make a run to Sam's for a new flat of water. A proper focus on Jesus, and there is spiritual, liquid life. Amen. Now, in the olden days, if you were a photographer, you had these cameras that you had to work the focus on. When you were getting ready to do your photo shoot, you had to work that focus. I don't know, I think it's already done for you now. All you do is just push a button. But you got to turn that dial. Amen. A proper focus on Jesus, and there is spiritual, liquid life. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Out of our bellies shall flow. Amen. Amen. Just like the Bible, just like the Bible, just like the Bible says, I got that Holy Ghost. You know it. Down in my soul, and it's just like the Bible says. Amen. Amen. Liquid life. That's what that is. That's liquid life. The Holy Ghost. Amen. In the book of Exodus, amen, a rock followed God's people for 40 years. Can you imagine? A rock. Now, how do you suppose that rock followed them? In my imagination, I like to think perhaps it grew legs. We don't know, do we? We don't know, do we? The word said it followed them. I don't know. Maybe the last one in line had to pick it up and throw it to the front. Nevertheless, a rock followed them. A rock that water flowed from. Isn't that what it said? A rock that water flowed from. Amen. That watered everything and everyone in the wilderness. It was one of the greatest miracles in the Bible. Jesus is our rock. Amen. In the New Testament, the rock does not follow us, but we follow the rock. Amen. Prudential. Prudential Insurance used to pride themselves on being the rock. Now, some of you younger ones probably have no idea what I just said. But nonetheless, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. But we have the rock following inside of us, a well of living water. Amen. Feeling dry? Get your eyes. Get your heart, get your mind on Jesus. Amen. Talk to him. Get in his word. Worship him. Be thankful unto him. And bless his holy name. Amen. And you will begin to feel the effect of that bubbling, flowing, life-giving, liquid faith. Begin to revitalize your soul. Amen. Used to be an old Sunday school song. It's bubbling, it's bubbling, it's bubbling in my soul. They're singing and shouting since Jesus made me whole. Some folks don't understand it, yet I can't keep it quiet. You're looking at me funny, Brother Josh. It's bubbling, 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 bubbling day and night. Okay, I'm finished with that. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. There's a river of life flowing out of us. Amen. This river of life makes the lame to walk, makes the blind to see. There's a river of life flowing out through me. Amen. Spring up a well within my soul. Spring up a well and make me whole. Hallelujah, Jesus. Just like I had to first recognize the condition of that plant, we need to recognize the condition of our own heart. Amen. At that point, the miracle of the water will begin to show its effect. Not effect, but effect. Amen. I have found that Jesus is my refreshing, my renewing, and restoration. Amen. Give him praise. Amen. Amen. Liquid life. Amen. In him. By him, through him, we live, breathe, and have our being. Amen. It's all in him. Amen. The mighty God is Jesus. The Prince of Peace is he. The everlasting Father. The King eternally. Amen. 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 I love those old time camp meeting style songs. Amen. Them old songs could minister something to you. Them old songs were written by people that came out of something. Amen. And I'm not necessarily bashing today's music. But I got into the van the other day, and my wife had on 92.5, I think it was. I hope I'm correct. And there was this bang, 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 ding, ding. I thought, Lord, have mercy. What in the name of sense is she listening to? And as soon as that rendition was finished, there came a scripture reading. I thought, oh my, okay. Okay. Amen. Click. You know something? God is like the water cycle. Amen. There is vapor. There is water. There is ice. Different forms. But it's all water. Let that ice cube lay on the countertop. Amen. Put that ice cube in a hot pan. Amen. It is like God. Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Different forms, but it's the same God. Amen. The ways of God are many, but they are always right and perfect for what we need at the time. Can you say amen? The ways of God are many. We will never begin to comprehend the ways of God. In our humanness, we will never begin to understand His ways. We will learn to trust Him. Amen. Amen. Job said it. Though God slay me, yet will I trust Him. Amen. I'm not getting off on Brother Lewis's deal. If you wasn't here Saturday night, you just missed it. I think they might have the DVD back there, maybe, perhaps. But since you wasn't here Saturday night, it's now going to cost you $20. You could have gotten it Saturday night for $5, but the rate has gone up. Amen. Water is one of the greatest secrets to life on this planet. God called land out of water, didn't He? This biosphere of land, water, and air is miraculously regulated by perpetual photosynthesis. Amen. I got that word out. Respiration and bacterial regeneration. It supports the life cycles of everything living. Oh, my goodness, I sound like a 12-year-old boy. God scattered dry seed everywhere, then raised up mist to water it. Amen. Why do you think they thought old Noah was stupid? They'd never seen it rain. What's this old man talking about rain? What in the world is rain? Why do you think they think we're crazy when we talk about the coming of the Lord? What do you mean the coming of the Lord? We've never seen the coming of the Lord. Amen. Amen. It's going to happen. We're going to see Him. We're going to see Him. We're going to see Him. Amen. We're going to see Him. If we don't have our heart in tune with this living water, we ain't going to hear that trumpet sound. We're going to continue sleeping in our bed. That trumpet sounded. and I didn't hear it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Amen. We better get our eyes off of this world. We better get our eyes on Jesus. Amen. This world don't have anything for you, young person. It don't have anything for you. Amen. Your friends will love you until you run out of money. Then they will drop you like a hot potato. And where will you be then? Oh, my. Water, it supports the life cycles of everything living. God scattered dry seeds everywhere, then raised up mist to water it, according to Genesis, the first chapter in verse 11. Amen. Isaiah 55, verse 10 through 11. For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven. Oh my, we could have used a little snow in July, couldn't we? When it was over 100 degrees outside. Yeah. And the snow from heaven and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth. And make it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Liquid life, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Verse 11, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. God's word will not go back to him void. Amen. What I'm endeavoring to try to speak to you tonight will not go back to God void. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm telling you, I feel like singing. Liquid life equals Jesus Christ. Liquid life better than a McDonald's sweet tea. Now, I have said a lot, because I like McDonald's sweet tea. But the life of Jesus Christ is better than McDonald's sweet tea. Better than cold Weiler's lemonade on a summer's day in Bastrop, Texas, when you can see the heat rising up off of the street. Amen. Nothing quenches thirst better than water. Amen. Diet Coke can't quench it. A&W root beer can't compare. Sun-kissed orange will make you thirst soon after. Whatever your pleasure may be, and I do hope that your pleasure is on the less adult beverage. Amen. Sipping saints. Sipping saints. There ain't no such thing. There ain't no such thing. Sipping saints. Oh, I don't think there's anything wrong with having a glass of wine with your meal. And therein is the problem. You don't think there's anything wrong with it. When the Word of God tells us,
Don't let it make a mockery out of us. Amen. Amen, Wyatt. Amen. 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 Let me be transparent with you just a moment. When I came back to the Lord back in 1983, my Lord, has it been that long? Amen. I got out there and I tasted of this old world. I thought I was, you know, living it up, having a good time. Amen. I smoked. I drank. Caroused. I was young then, so I fought. And when I came back to the Lord in 1983, if I went to the grocery store or wherever store, and I would walk past that liquor aisle, my mouth would water for it. I'm telling you the honest truth. It would water for it. Don't tell me you cannot overcome it. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You don't have to go to AA to do it. You get you a good dose of HG. Amen. I know what I'm talking about tonight. I know what I'm talking about. I know what he delivered me from. Amen. Now, nicotine wasn't so much of a problem to lay down. But that alcohol was. And I told the Lord, I can't do it by myself. I said, God, you know I cannot do it within myself. He's faithful, he's just, and he will do it. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Liquid life is Jesus Christ. He's the way, he's the truth, and the life. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Jesus is my Savior. I shall not be moved. In his loving favor, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree planted by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Just like a tree planted by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Just like a tree planted by the water, I shall not be moved. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. You decide. Do you want corrupt, evil things to come out of your belly? Or do you want a river of life that comes out of your belly? Amen. Amen. Something to think about, isn't it? Amen. Don't you love the Lord this evening? Amen. He's everything he said he would be, and then some. I appreciate you tonight. I appreciate you allowing me to speak to you this evening. Amen. I don't take this opportunity for granted. Amen. You know, I'm nothing. I'm nothing. I'm nothing without him. Amen. I'm nothing without Him. And each time that I stand before you, I do not take it for granted. Amen. I pray. I get the leading of the Lord. Amen. I don't want to get up here and just spin my tires. Amen. We got heaven to gain and hell to shun. Amen. You don't hear so much on hell anymore. But just because we don't hear it, don't mean it ain't so. Amen. If you miss that trumpet, you don't have a choice. It's hell. That's right. It's hell. I love you, therefore I tell you. It's either heaven or hell. There is no in-between. Lord, I wish there was an in-between. There is no in-between. It's either black or it's white. There is not a gray area. Amen. Liquid life. Amen. Give the Lord praise as Pastor comes.
I certainly enjoyed that ministering tonight. Brother Strong, I'll be honest with you, I like it's transparent. I feel a realness coming out in his spirit. As much as you would like to transmit, means communicating to people. I will say this. We really communicate of not what we think we are or what we would like to be. We really communicate of really the person who we really are. And Brother Strong is communicating to who he really is. Now, he said some things and I agree with him. We're not perfect. But I desire to be. And if I desire to be, I can run on that. And I can go with you a long ways in your imperfection. I can put up with a lot of imperfection if somebody says, man, I want to correct. And I want to do better. The kingdom of heaven is always about doing better. Improving. Because your mortal beings don't tell me that you can't improve. If you're a mortal being and you're walking around on this earth and you're not changing, I'm going to say it again, and you're not changing, then you're stuck. I say it again, you're stuck, and you're in a dangerous place if you're stuck and you've been stuck there for a while. Praise God. It's all about change. It's all about, I want to improve my prayer time. It's all about, I want to improve myself, my self-attitude. It's all about improving my reading skills. It's all about improving my relationships with one another. It's all about tying myself to you. And it's all about it. Improvement. Raise your hands and love God right quick. Love Him right now. Just love Him. Tell God something. Just tell Him something tonight. Give Him your heart tonight. Give Him your heart tonight. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, man, I love the Holy Ghost power. Amen. Nothing like this. You can search the world over and you'll never find God in this fashion. The gods of this world cannot be competitive with Him. And I'm going to tell you another thing. Programs and denominational churches, cannot compete with Holy Ghost and the anointing of God. And that's not to put anybody down. We can get the same way. Praise God. Shake somebody's hand. Be friendly. Just love people. And let God be God. Love and appreciate every one of you. We'll see you Sunday for sure.